I'm Dr Manmohan Sharma. I'm a veterinarian. My father inspired me to be a veterinarian. He was doing veterinary practice in Delhi since 1952. We used to go to a Delhi zoo and we had interaction with, you know, Gwalior Zoo. And, you know, he was very hospitable. You know, clients coming with the pets, normally they were at our home taking, you know, a coffee and, you know, sitting with us. So my interaction with animal lovers, even, you know, the jungle animals, has been extreme and important in building my personality. 1976, I graduated and joined my father. Those days, the practice only remained to nearly one-room hospitals, clinics, and there was just a stethoscope and thermometer. And doctors, you know, gut feel would always guide him to choose a protocol for treatment. And more important, always has been to interact with the client and give the client some feeling of, you know, comfort. Sometimes, you know, the pet is just close to the trailing end of his life, maybe 13 years, 14 years, 16 years of age. And those are the situations where, from the veterinary point of view, we can hardly offer anything. But the pet has to go because of organic failures. You have looked after the pet well. You should not feel guilty that the pet is going now. Then, you know, after 76, there was a little spurt in the veterinary industry. We had more tools, diagnostic tools in hands, like the ultrasound, x-rays. And those were the days when, for the dogs and cats, there were limited medications. We were using the medicines used for large animals, you know, buffaloes and cows. And then in 2005, both my sons, Dr. Kunal and Dr. Bhanu, they joined me. And now we are happy that we are able to give better service to the pets and, you know, pet parents. We are doing the spinal surgeries. We are doing, you know, the soft tissue surgeries, laparoscopes, endoscopy, gastroscopy. I mean, all these modern tools, they give us, you know, opportunity to serve the pet industry in a better way. You know, some of the problems these days, they are arising because of bad management, maybe the food allergies or giving wrong type of food. Some dog foods are available in the market, which are pellet foods, but many times, you know, pets, they become obese because of offering too much of food and a very lethargic lifestyle. I mean, the working dog like German Shepherds, the Golden Retrievers, Labradors, they are belonging to a working strain of dogs, and if they are eating and, you know, having a comfortable, restful life, they become obese and old age problems, they creep in. Then we have, you know, special needs according to the disease condition of the pet. A pet may be diabetic, a pet may have kidney problems, he may have, you know, a very sensitive stomach as far as digestion is concerned. But many times we have find pets, they are very, very fussy about, you know, any change in the diet plan. So here the pet parent got to be very firm in, you know, handling the situation and trying to, you know, coax the pet to accept the new food plan. You know, a puppy food will, or a kitten food will, have more of proteins because the body is growing, more muscle mass is being added up. But once a pet has grown up, you know, to the adult age, the toy dogs or the, you know, medium-sized dogs, they are fully grown up by 9 months to about 18 months. You know, after 24 months of age, or after, you know, 9 or 18 months of age, the food habits should change. Less of protein should be there because the growth phase has stopped. And of course, anybody who's keeping pets, they have some sentiments, a very special corner in their mind, you know, for the pets. And the pets also, you know, understand this. They are faithful or they're choosy in picking up, you know, which family member they are more close to. So things that like that continue, but destiny takes its own toll.